poison slug.
Poison.
Poison spreading through my body.
Did you come here for answers? There are none. The call of Korriban is strong, but it is the call of the dead. I have studied you, immersed myself in you. I know the paths you walked in exile. I know your teacher. I know the fires that raged upon the Ducks and Moon while the Republic died around you. You know war. You know battle. And I know of KotOR. You know what it means to be broken. The one who travels with you will destroy you, as she did me. I can end it before it begins. She clings to hope that perhaps she can train one as great as her first. She is a fool who escaped death once. She will not do so again. I want her to die and see all that she has built cast down. All that she holds dear in shards at her feet. You are a wretched thing, a thing of weakness and fear. You are her apprentice in name only. I am the master, and that is why you will die.
Take him down with you.
Sion. He cannot be defeated. He is not a beast of flesh and blood. This is not a battle that can be won. Flee. There will be another time, but it is not now, not here, while Korriban runs through him.
Do not harm her. I command it. She has earned this. She and I will meet again.
My life for yours. I will answer what I can. It is not a subject which I have spoken of since its destruction. The planet was not destroyed. It remains. It orbits, dead in space. But nothing lives on its surface. It echoes, but there's no one left to hear it. I am not certain I did. I was there when the planet died. To see everything around you extinguished. It was as if I was blinded. It was as if the force had been bled from the world. I imagine there are worse deaths, worse pain. But if there are, I do not know them. I was the only living thing remaining on the planet of KotOR. And my life, my agony, was a flicker in the darkness that was the planet. All that I had been connected to had been severed. The planet was not destroyed. It remains. It orbits, dead in space. but nothing lives on its surface. It echoes, but there's no one left to hear it.
Oops.
Through the cave is just ahead. I believe you are strong enough to explore the tomb ahead. This tomb has not been plundered. Its mysteries may still be intact, but so might its traps. Take great caution.
I just can't move forward. Can you do this without me?
I sense a great presence within this tomb. Master, it calls to you. You will have to face the challenges of this tomb alone. Are you ready?
Do not heed the words of the Jedi Council. The Republic will fall if we do not act now. Already the Mandalorians have taken three systems along the Rim. They will only grow more powerful with time. Come stand with me. We will use our might to help the Republic in its time of need. Join Revan and I. Together, we will battle this menace. The Jedi Council is wise, but will take too long to deal with this threat. We must act now to stop the Mandalorians. I have heard of you. Your masters speak well of you, of your skills in battle. Join us. The Jedi Council is wise, but can make mistakes. History has proven this time and time again. The Council seems content to watch, to debate, while entire systems fall to the Mandalorians. If we don't act now, there may be no Republic army to assist in the future. I sense you will join us. What are your reasons? Who we truly are is defined by our actions. To deny your actions is to deny yourself, your nature. You show weakness with your words. It was within our power to end the war, and the Council chose to debate behind closed doors while planets burned. Their vaunted wisdom bred only in action, and that would have led to destruction greater than anything born of the dark side. So, if you could do it all again, the real question is, would you? The Mandalorians await on the edge of space, eager to crush the Republic. You know how this turns out. Would you do it any different, knowing what it costs you? Knowing what it costs the rest? So knowing all that would transpire, would you still follow Revan and I? Excellent. And now you are all alone. Would you join me now? You didn't follow Revan and I down our path. Join us. Your journey hasn't ended yet. She didn't join us that day, but in time, she came to our way of thinking. And even before then, she wavered and wondered what would have happened. It is a familiar path. There were those who wished to follow you to war, yet remain behind. They came to hate you for the choices they wish to make. The first lesson will be carved in your flesh. Pain is the ultimate teacher, and the lesson begins now.
Com says we've lost another heavy droid transport. How can we break through the Mandalorian lines without support? The path is mined and the place is crawling with enemies. I know we've got our orders to press forward, but we're at quarter strength. We can't, General. It's impossible. We need to retreat. General, it would be suicide to go forward. There's just too few of us. We already lost half the men just getting to the path. They've got the rest of the company pinned down by the crash site. You can't possibly ask the troops to go forward. If you ask us to charge, will it make a difference? Will our sacrifice mean something? We will press forward if you ask it. The path is mine. If you ask us to charge, there will be losses, General. Thank you, General. Thank you. And now we fight.
You are to be commended for making it this far. You've revisited the dark moments of your past, and now you must face the present. Your confusion is natural. The others and I will help you understand.
Get away from her! She's a dark Jedi.
I've had enough of your snide contempt. I will protect myself from this foul-mouthed ruffian.
Hey,
What's the commotion here?
Stay out of this, Beodor. This is a personal dispute between Atten and myself.
You're threatening Atten with a lightsaber, and I'm supposed to just stay out of it? No.
The three of you would challenge me? You sorely underestimate the power of the Force.
Think again, Kreia. Your dark influence will end.
Your friends are all arrayed against me. Will you stand for this? You, of all people, would judge me so. Am I not worthy of redemption?
This trial, I am impressed. Sometimes, a momentary insight is worth lifetimes of experience. You may not yet understand what you learned here. That wisdom will come in the future. You overestimate the power of the tomb. Any change you feel is coming from within yourself. Instinctually, you know your true path. Trust in your feelings. They will lead you in conquering the many challenges that the future holds for you. Search the room you are in. You should be able to unlock a passage that leads outside the tomb.